Okay, today I'm going to start breaking down some words. We're going to go away from our recent study on Ezekiel 31 to look at the word world, synonymous words for world and earth in the Bible, just so we could start getting some better definitions of these basic words that have to do with our understanding of the earth. And if we're looking at the flat earth or the no force thingamajig. Okay, there are four Greek words which are thus translated: world, earth, etc. And it is most important that we should be in each occurrence carefully distinguished of which one, because they're all very different. They are as follows. First one is cosmos. First Greek word, the world as created, ordered, and arranged, hence it is used in the lexicons for the Hebrew word rendered ornaments. So the world was seen as an ornament. It's a beautiful thought, isn't it? See Exodus 33, 5 and 6, Isaiah 49:18, Jeremiah 4:30, and Ezekiel 7:20 for uses of the word as an ornament, cosmos. It denotes the opposite of what man has called chaos. Makes sense to me. Which Yahweh never created. He did not create chaos. Chaos came into being in Genesis 2. Genesis 1, 2. Isaiah 45:18, Genesis 1, 2. The Hebrew word bara, which is actually also in the first line of the Bible. Barashit, to create. In the beginning, Yahweh created. That's the root word of the in the beginning, Yahweh created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was, which is actually in Hebrew, became, without form and void. That is, darkness was upon the face, darkness became upon the face of the deep. And the earth was, that word is actually, it's actually should be, became, and void and without form is tohu va'u. Void, without form, waste. It was not created, tohu, but became tohu. We'll look at that on a separate day. That's a whole study within itself. For the Hebrew word baha means bara, means not only to create, but that which was created, that which was created was beautiful. So these cutting down these massive trees, mega trees, and the earth as we now see it is not beautiful. Koyaanisqatsi is the Indians in the West call it life out of balance. The root meaning to carve, to plane, to polish. Cosmos. The root of that word is to carve, to plane, to polish implies order and beauty. So you could see how it was rendered an ornament. The second word for world and earth is aeon. And it actually means an age or age time. So that's why I often say this world age, because it's the same world. It's a different age of the world. You know, I mean, it's been destroyed and recreated many times, but same basic center of the universe that Yahweh made for his specific purpose. It's been recreated. And so many times we're looking at world ages, not a total oblivion. An age or age time, the duration of which is indefinite, may be limited or extended as the context of each occurrence may demand. The root of aeon is expressed by the Hebrew olam, which is often rendered kingdom. It's often with the word melech, king, and olam, kingdom, his age, kingdom age. That's the Hebrew. An indefinite or unknown or concealed duration, just as we speak of the patriarchal age or the golden age. Hence it has come to denote any given period of time and characterized by a special form of definite administration or dispensation. In the plural we have the Hebrew olam, olaim, and the Greek aeones, used of ages, with a succession of age times, and abiding from age to age. From this comes the adjective aeonos, used of an unrestricted duration as distinct from a peculiar, particular, or limited age time. These age times must be distinct as they cannot be added to or multiplied, as in the expression aeons or eons. These ages or age times were all prepared and arranged by Yahweh. And there is a constant distinction in the New Testament between this age and the coming age. We see this in Matthew 12:32, Hebrews 1:2, and Ephesians 1:21. This age is characterized by such passages as Matthew 13:24-30 and 36-43, Mark 4:19, and Mark 10:30, Romans 12:2, 1 Corinthians 2:8, 2 Corinthians 4:4, Galatians 1:4, Ephesians 2:2. Okay. Sorry about that. My memory said it was full. So, I have to go out to my truck and charge. It's getting dark here, but I'll try to finish. And you might not even be able to see me, but hopefully you'll hear me. Okay, I'll try to wrap this up. The conjunction of these ages is spoken of as the Suntalia, marking the end of one age and the beginning of another. Other definite durations are mentioned, but they always refer to some unknown or prolonged continuance, the end of which cannot be seen, such as the end of life, characterized in Exodus 21:6. Hence, the Hebrew priesthood was so characterized because its end could not be foreseen, as in Exodus 40:15, 1 Samuel 1:22, and Hebrews 7:12. It is used in the same way of other connections. The word aeon, age. Matthew 21:19 and John 8:35 also use the word aeon or age. The Greek word. The third word translated use synonymous word for world or earth is the Greek word oikoimene, the world as inhabited. It is from the verb orkio, to dwell. This is maybe particular interest to us as flat earth people. You know, there's actually a distinction between the world that is inhabited, and is known to be inhabited, and apparently they wouldn't have a distinction unless there was a potential world that was not inhabited. World that is not inhabited. It means to dwell, those places where people dwell. It is used of the habitable world as distinct from the cosmos. So here we understand the world is the cosmos. That's the cosmos, this world. Some of it's habitable, some of it's not, but it's all this world. It's not, the Bible doesn't teach, nor does any of the Greek or ancient language teach anything but this world. The stars are stars, and they're mentioned throughout the Bible. I'm still doing a study on them today, the Pleiades and such, and they're not seen as other worlds or other planets or in the cosmos. This is the cosmos, this world. Is used to have a world as distinct from the cosmos, which means the creative world. So there is no other creative world. There are the stars. Stars are different. Hence, it is used in a more limited and special sense of the Roman Empire at the time, which was then the predominant inhabited world, as they saw it, at least from the perspective of the Bible, of the Bible writers. see Luke 2:1, Luke 4:5, and Luke 21:26 about the Roman Empire. There's a fourth world that is translated world or earth, and it is Gi, land as distinct from water, or earth as distinct from heaven, or region or territory, use of one special land or country as distinct from other countries in which people dwell, each on its own soil. So we have it, the four words rendered world or earth. Of course, those don't get into the Hebrew words like terah, terra, and such. We'll look at those in different time when we have more light. Hopefully you can see me a little bit. And I'm not just talking in the dark here. That's okay, I am. Well, prayers for everyone, and hope that these teachings on flat earth and new trees are in some way useful to you. I know that they're useful to me. I'm just learning these things and reading this stuff right along with you. And I'm just trying to keep you up sharing with what I'm finding out. And some things I've already known quite a time from studying with such incredible teachers like Arnold Murray at Shepherd's Chapel, one of my great heroes, and some other good teachers here and there, few. Most of it just self-study with a good Bible. Right now, all I have is a good Bible. I don't even have a concordance, and I don't have the internet. So I'm just winging all this study on my own, just me and my trusty Bible. So when I get things more together, when I get the internet back, I get a house that has electricity, I'm using a little $1 solar light is a flashlight right now. I will be able to break down the words a little bit better when I have more reference material, like a concordance. It's my strong concordance. It's up on my mountain, but my back is so hurting that I can't even walk up my mountain to get my back last time I went up there to get things. So I'm just trying to recover now. Pray for me, my recovery. My little shack here I'm working on. Get a roof on it before winter. Right now I just have wood and plastic. And the plastic is tearing apart due to cats being on it. I tore it all up. I love you guys, and Yeshua, in the name of Yeshua, the blessings of Yahweh be upon you, and may you learn all you need to know about the flat earth and the forests, and stick in the Word, because every day in the Word is a good day, because Yeshua is the living Word.